Very good morning. I am Dr. Manoj Kumar Singh and I am working as assistant professor in the Department of Livestock Production Management at Sardar Vallabhbhai Bhai Patel University of Agriculture and Technology, Meerut, Uttar Pradesh. So I chosen my topic for presentation is poultry housing system. So let's discuss about what is poultry housing system. We can see the improvement what we will made in case of poultry. It is due to the nutritional, environmental and genetic improvement. So these are the factors which will make improvement in poultry. So along with this, we can see that what is the importance of housing. So housing is the thing that which will provide comfort and protection to the birds and their scientific management in a controlled manner, which also helps in easy, convenient and economic operations. And if these easy, convenient, economic operations are there, then it will also reduce the total cost of production, and in turn it will maximize the flock performance, and also it ensures better health and welfare. And it will provide the microclimatic conditions which is optimum to the birds. And in small space, if all these conditions are managed, then the stocking density also we can increase. And this housing can also provide optimum and uniform growth rate. So coming to the housing systems, how many types are there? We can see these systems is divided into three categories, which includes free range or extensive system, semi-intensive system and intensive system. Intensive system is further divided into slat cum litter system, slatted floor system, deep litter system and cage system. And this cage system is further divided into steer, step or California cage system, battery or vertical cage system, and individual cage system. We will discuss one by one with each system. So coming to the free range system, this is the oldest system and which is adopted only when we are having the adequate land. So, and in this we will rear the poultry or let them loose on the ground or field, which is called as range. So a range should have to provide the shelter and greens for poultry, also feed, water and shed. In this system, the foraging is the major source of feeding of the birds. So they will forage on the weeds and seeds which is available in the ground or insects, and shelter is usually provided by temporary roofing supported by ordinary poles. So in this system, the stocking density, the number of birds can be housed is 300 to 400 per hectare. So this system is almost outdated now, but in village areas we can see some peoples will adopt this system. Next is the semi-intensive system. It is commonly used by small scale producers. So in this housing system, birds are reared halfway in houses and halfway in range system, and these are confined to houses in night, or shelter is provided mostly to birds in night. So they will daytime they will feed outside in just like free range system, and we are also giving a run access to run also. House in this system, the house is simple with thatched roof, littered earth floor or slatted floor we can use in this system, and this also provide the protection of from inclement weathers, predators and shade. So stocking density in this system is 4 to 5 birds per meter square in houses. Next is the folding unit system. In this system we will combine the run and house system. So part of which is covered by the wired mesh and the remainder will be solid walls. So a unit of this folding unit can measure around 6 meters by 1.5 meter. for 6 to 18 birds can be reared in this area. So floor space requirement we will give around 2 square meter per bird, and this folding unit is moved to other grassland areas every day, or 2 weeks or 3 weeks interval if range system is large. Similar to deep litter system, but requires more space, and a considerable amount of litter for the yards is also available when the birds, when we will put this folding system in range. So these birds will defecate, or their droppings will act as a fertilizer for green food. Also it will available green food for the birds, and but this system is more expensive and less durable. Next system is the deep litter system. In this, poultry birds are kept in large pens on floors, mainly used for broilers. Broilers are those birds which are reared for meat purpose. So in this system, floor is covered with litter material, which can be like straw, sawdust or leaves, dried leaves, up to the depth of 2 to 3 inches. So in this, the density of birds, we can take 5 to 7 birds per square meter. So it is, in this system, it is easy for the birds to access for feed, water, and egg collection is also easy in this system, and it will provide a good protection. Only disadvantage of this system is that it requires high quality litter and litter-borne diseases. Next is slatted or wire floor system. It is a small house with a slatted or wire mesh floor. So slats are those wooden pieces of 2.5 to 5 cm of width, which is placed 2.5 cm apart, running through the length of the house. So slats placed 3 feet above the ground to allow accumulation of droppings. And in this case, the bird density can be used 6 to 8 per square meter. Feeding, watering and egg collection handled from outside the house. Cooler houses, but expensive and suitable for adult birds only. So one more system is there. It is combination of slatted floor and deep litter. So in this case, 60% area is covered as a slat area, which we use slatted floor, and 40% as a litter area, just what we will use in deep litter system. So slat on other side of the house against each side walls, leaving the central portion for the litter floor. So this area is raised above the concrete floor, the slatted area, by 0.5 meter or more to accumulate manure below the slatted area. In this system, waters and feeders are placed on the slatted area, and the bird density we can keep up to 5 to 7 per square meter, and it is expensive and complicated management. Aviaries is also now in use, this system. So it is a multi-tiered building for cage-free housing, and it's having a several levels of floorings are there, and its uses of vertical spaces like perches and platforms we will use in this aviary system, which allows the birds to jump to different levels. And the high density we can rear in this, maybe up to 25 birds per square meter can be reared in this system. So next is the cage system. So it is the rearing of poultry on raised wire netting floor in smaller compartments. This is called cage. Suitable for keeping high density of birds when space is limitations. So when space is less, we can use this type of system. Then specific managemental practices can be followed in this system. And this, what are the feeders and waters in the utensils which we provide feed and water, these are attached to the cage from outside, except nipple waters, for which the pipeline is installed through the cages. Droppings are either collected in trays, which is placed underneath the cages, on the belts or on floor or deep pit under the cages. So in this system, the recommended floor space is for chicks, which is about 0 to 8 weeks, 0.3 square feet, and for growers, which is about 9 to 16 weeks old, it is about 0.5 square feet, and for layers which are above 17 weeks. So this space requirement is 0.6 square feet. Environmentally controlled or modern housing system. It is the latest system, which is an intensive, coming under intensive system of rearing. It is the most poultry operations are intensive type houses with environmentally controlled houses. And in this system, the inside conditions are maintained as near as to the bird's optimum requirements. Just like we can see, this temperature is 24 degrees Celsius and relative humidity is 50 to 60%. It is maintained in this system. It is a closed building with no windows, and its longitudinal axis should be preferably east to west, and with big exhaust fans on the west side while evaporating cooling packs on east side, and with the automatic feeding and drinking system is installed inside. It is a fully controlled system with no manual controls. Feeding system, watering, manure collection, egg collection, these all are mechanized and automatic. So this environmentally controlled houses, which helps to achieve better feed conversion ratio and improves production, we can manage the care of birds, control diseases and meet other safe breeding conditions. And adopting with this system, we can get one extra batch or cycle per year per shed. So, but this disadvantage is this too much costly. Initial cost is too much compared to other systems. But in long run, it is feasible. So coming to the conclusion, we can tell that future of the poultry housing and managements seems certain to be strongly affected by changing consumer and public preferences and perceptions, as well as the increasing involvement of multinational retailers in setting standards and sometimes global standards for poultry production practices. As system evolves, so too will welfare concerns, along with the research, technologies and applications needed to address those concerns. Here are the references.